he was doing with the women and in the temple, Eli did not fire them. Eli is supposed to fire his sons, get rid of them. But he didn't do anything. And they blaspheme, Eli's sons blaspheme against God. So this is why Eli, amen, they didn't have no open vision in those days. No man had a vision. No man hear from God, didn't have the capability to hear from God. Because why? Sin. Sin. Go ahead. And the Lord called Samuel. Samuel, amen. The Lord called Samuel, amen. But Samuel didn't even know the voice of the Lord. So Samuel thought this was Eli. Because Eli is his spiritual father. Because y'all remember the vow that Hannah made with God. That if you give me a male child, I will give him back to you. Amen. So, amen. So, the name Samuel is given to a Hebrew baby. Amen. It's given to the Hebrew babies. Amen. The name Samuel means, this is what it means, the presence of God. So Samuel literally had a destiny name, because the Jews would name their children based on destiny. They'll name them a name that really have a lot to do with who they are and where they what they're supposed to be doing. Amen. And some of the Bible scholars says that during this time that when God was calling Samuel, it was in the year 1154 BC. This is the time that God was calling Samuel. 1154 BC. That Samuel heard the voice of God but did not recognize the voice of God.
Go ahead.
And he ran unto Eli and says, "Here am I.
But thou
callest me.
And he said, "I called not."
And now Eli is saying, I didn't call you. I didn't call you. Since for the youth tonight, I want to encourage y'all to learn the voice of God. Get familiar with the voice of God. Samuel, mother Hannah, gave him to Eli to work in the temple. And Eli's job was to train him. He trained him. But Eli did not did what he's supposed to do. And the reason why I say is that, because if Eli did train him, then Samuel would have known the voice of God. Samuel thought this was Eli that was calling him.
Amen.
Do you know, because of what Eli allowed his sons to commit in the sin in the temple, it caused God to really be angry with Eli because of the sins of his sons. Amen.
And the Lord called yet again, Samuel. And Samuel rose and went to Eli and said, "Here am I."
No. How many times that the Lord called Samuel, and Samuel went to Eli? Now, I understand the first time. But the second time, Eli should know that was the Lord. But this is how far Eli was backslid. Because when you backslid, you don't even have no spiritual discernment. So even Eli was able to tell Samuel that that's the voice of the Lord. Next time you call, you answer. That means that Samuel, I do understand, a lot of Bible scholars say that Samuel was what, 3 years old? Not as a child. So God called Samuel as a child. And God called each and every one of you all before the foundation of the world. So it is not an accident. It's not a mistake that you are here tonight. Because the calling has been confirmed before your mother known your daddy.
Amen.
Amen. Glory be to God. So God had a plan and purpose for Samuel's life, right? Amen. God had a plan and a purpose for who? Samuel. God have a plan and purpose for each and one of you. Your young youth, God have a plan and purpose for your life. In spite of how it looked, God have a plan and purpose for your life. In spite of how many setbacks you have, God have a plan and purpose for your life. I don't care what they tell you, God have a plan and a purpose for your life. I don't care how tired you get, you continue to trust God. God has something important for you. And God is taking you somewhere. The Bible says that he that watcheth over Israel neither. So God doesn't sleep. Anytime God promised to do something in your life, you can rest for sure to know that God is going to do it.
Amen.
Amen. You don't have to worry. Once God says what he's going to do, he is able and capable of doing it.
Amen.
Now, God sees Samuel, this young child. God look at him and God saw a prophet. God is looking at you tonight and God is seeing prophets. God is seeing ministers. God is seeing pastors. God is seeing bishops. God is seeing leaders. And this is why the enemy doesn't want you to know that what God has placed in you. He doesn't want you to know it. Because the minute you begin to know what God has placed in you, ain't nothing that the devil can do against you. Hallelujah. Amen. So we have pastors in here. These youth are pastors. Youth pastors. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, they are. We have great young man and great young woman in here tonight.
Hallelujah.
That is going to do marvelous things. Amen. That the hands of God is on their life.
Yes.
And nothing the devil can do to stop God from doing what God has promised and purposed in himself to do.
Thank you.
Amen. And if you fall back, you get back up, brush yourself, and continue to run the race.
Amen.
Amen. Because when God has them ready, what the Bible says, who God did foreknown, then he also did call. And whom he did call, then he also did predestine. Hallelujah. I want to tell you tonight that God has predestined you for greatness. Samuel was predestined for greatness, but Samuel didn't know it. Eli didn't even know the greatness that is in Samuel. My God. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen, because amen, amen, and that's why God had Samuel, amen, amen, receive a visitation from God, but Samuel didn't even know the God that was calling him. That's why I tell you all tonight that you must get familiar with the voice of God. There are many voices, but you gotta know, amen, when God speak, you gotta know it. Amen. Samuel was not yet been taught to know the voice of God. Amen. Go ahead.
Without this, call me.
Uh-huh.
And he answered, I call not my son. Lie down again.
My God, you hear that? How many times this is?
Two.
How many times?
That's the second time.
Again. Now watch this again. Read.
Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord.
Oh, this is the problem right there. Samuel did not yet know the Lord. See, this is why he didn't even know the voice of God. Because to know the Lord, you got to know the voice of God. If you don't know the voice of God, how could you know God? The Bible says Samuel was not yet know God. Amen. I want to encourage you to know God. To know God. To know God. Because the Bible says they that know God, they that know their God shall do what? Shall do what? Amen. So when you know your God, you can do what? Great exploit. Nobody can stop you when you know your God. So Samuel didn't know God. But it was not Samuel's problem that he didn't know God. It was Eli. Eli is supposed to be a teacher to teach Samuel God. Amen. But Eli didn't do it. Go ahead.
Neither was the word of the Lord yet revealed.
You heard that? He didn't know God, and neither the word of the Lord has been yet revealed unto him. So he has not yet even received the word of God. That's why Eli didn't teach him the word of God. Eli didn't do his job. But Samuel had a call on him from a child. God told Jeremiah in Jeremiah 1, he says that I have chosen you before you was formed in your mother's womb. And so the calling is not when you just came. The calling has been taking place in eternity. In eternity, there's no time. So when God get ready to call you, he called you in eternity.